You just really need to slow down and take it easy on the commute home tonight. I know you want to get home quick, but today's not the day to kind of go ahead of the speed, so to speak. Look at all the pounding water. I-4, Conroy, Mall of Millennia there. This is southbound there, headed towards the attractions, and on the other side as well, headed north towards Orlando. Just, you know the deal. Just got to take your time. Don't forget to log on to WESH.com. Use that interactive radar before you head home. Kind of see where the heaviest cells are. And then when you get home, you can track it with us like we're doing right now. Here's Storm Tracker Radar. Two cells in particular here. One east of Holapa. Headed over towards Lake Poinsett and Cocoa here rather quickly. And moving off to the northeast now at about 25 to 30 miles an hour. And then another cell right over Cocoa Beach. Going to take that turn up towards the Cape Canaveral area here very shortly. So a lot of lightning here. Just slow down, take it easy, and we'll get you home there safely. Wider perspective. Let me show you what it looks like right now out there across central Florida. The first alert Doppler radar. You can see the biggest complex now of showers and storms right over the Kennedy Space Center. That big complex of showers and storms just north of Sanford beginning to wane. That is certainly some good news. But look at all the heavy water now along and over I-95, A1A, over towards the Rock Ledge area. Weather watcher there phoning it in, letting us know that finally getting some heavy rain. Looks like the dome is lifted off of Rock Ledge for a change. There's Cape Canaveral. There's Courtney. Steady rains here to the tune of about a half an inch to an inch of rain. Merritt Island right now, very heavy rain and lots of lightning in and around Merritt Island. Downtown, we just showed you the DOT cams, and you can see the 417 also looking wet over towards 434. Looks like Sanford now beginning to finally dry out, but already 1.25 inches of rain up I-95 now over towards Sam Sula, New Smyrna Beach, Port Orange. Got a couple of showers your way, and up towards Daytona Beach off to the west. You may hear a quick clap of thunder like they're doing right now in Ormond by the Sea and Ormond Beach. Flagler Beach, you're quiet. Palm Coast, you're quiet. A few light of showers now over towards Eustace, Umatilla, back towards the south and west. We've got rain everywhere today. There's Lakeland, Polk City, soon to be Davenport. Some lighter showers working on in and area-wide for a change. Marion County getting a break in the action for one day. Rain total, Sanford, 1.25 inches of rain. Look at Daytona Beach approaching an inch of rain with that next slug coming on in. You may hit that total here within the next half hour. Ocala, 82, the warm spot right now, and also Palm Coast with a little bit of sunshine up there, running in the middle 80s. We take a look at the hour by hour. Moist southwest flow overnight tonight. We're going to keep that chance for showers in there overnight tonight. Overnight lows really aren't going to fall a whole lot from where we are right now, 70 to 75 degrees. If you're tired of the rain, you better take a flight out of town. But here's the reason why. We've got plenty more action on the way. We've got broad southwest flow aloft. We've got a front to the north. Thursday and Friday, a very, very wet scenario now here across all of Florida, not just northern, not just central, but a good chunk of the entire peninsula is going to be awfully wet Thursday night, and again on Friday as this front gradually begins to move into central Florida, then hopefully by the end of the weekend, pushing a little bit to the south of central Florida. It should be a little bit drier up towards Palm Coast and Daytona Beach by the weekend. But look at these rainfall totals now, 1 to 3 inches of rain here across central Florida between now and Saturday noontime. 74, 82, 80. In between now, a 70% chance for showers and storms on Thursday, a 70% chance for showers and storms on Friday. There's the improvement, but still wet as we head into the weekend. Highs approaching 90, rain chances running 40 to 50%.
Tony, thanks.